I'm in a 2021 Citroen e-C4 electric vehicle. This one is a Shine Plus, so top spec model. And in this video, I'm going to demonstrate the adaptive cruise control and the lane keep assist, where it all comes together to give you that sort of semi-autonomous driving when you're on main roads, A roads, dual carriageways and motorways. So I'm going along a dual carriageway here, and I can turn on the cruise control and I can then turn on lane keep assist. So this has got an adaptive cruise control. It's got a radar at the front which will keep me from the correct distance from a vehicle in front, not that there is any at the moment, but it is now also doing the lane keep. So it's doing all the steering and it's doing the driving. So you're meant to keep your hands on the steering wheel, every now and then you've got to touch it, but I'm taking my hands off so you can see on the video that I'm not steering the car and I've got all my feet and all my hands off and it's driving along. So we're about to come up behind a car, but let's just check that it's going to do this corner okay. I'm just going to touch the steering wheel a little bit. There we are, we've just moved a bit to get into the center of the lane, and it may well get confused at this bit because the lane has merged, two lanes have merged into one, but it seems to be handling it quite well. And we're now coming up behind the car, so the car is now slowing down. There, it's now slowing down. And that car's braking, as you can see, and we're now braking. So hopefully you can see my speed there, and it's handling that all very well. So what I wanted to do is show you on this bit of road, because there's some quite sharp corners here. Unfortunately, we're not really going fast enough. So we're now doing 36. But as you can see, it's taking the corner very well indeed. It can still see the lines and it's still driving. But I really wanted to approach this at 60 because it gets a bit hairy and some cars can't cope. So what I'll do is we'll go down the road a bit and I'll turn around and I'll do this again. But anyway, as we can see there, it's coping perfectly fine at the moment because our speed has dropped down. Oh, it's getting a bit close to that truck. Yeah, it's a bit close to that lane, that centre line, should I say. But it's pushed us back over and yeah, it is doing it just fine. Not perfect. Oh, I've got to touch the steering wheel. You saw there the message came up because it couldn't feel my hands on the steering wheel. So you've got to put a little bit of friction on the steering wheel so it knows you're still touching it. But that's a legal thing, which by the looks of it in the UK is going to change next year. The government are bringing in the new rules regarding self-driving, so things can finally start progressing. There we go, I'll touch the wheel again. But as you can see here, we've got a few corners and it is handling these perfectly fine. It can see the white lines. It's keeping us in the middle, a bit close to the middle there. It's keeping us in the middle of the lane, but it was getting a little bit close to the middle of the road there. And we've just got a bleep because there's a speed camera here and it's put it up there on the screen. I've got it in my heads-up display, which I doubt if you're going to see, but what you see on the screen there is what I've got in the heads-up display. I've got the 42 mile hour speed that we're currently doing. I've got a 50 mile hour roadside symbol to show the speed of the road. I've got the cruise control symbol showing this currently set to 60, which is too high. But then I've got all of this graphic here showing the road, the green lines down the side, and I've also got a green steering wheel symbol to show that it's doing the steering. But just then, as I was talking, it went to white. So when it goes to white, that means it can no longer see the edges of the road and the white lines, so it turns the steering off. So that's why you should be holding the steering wheel, because if it can't see where it's got to go, you've obviously got to be steering the car. So That little demo wasn't as good as I thought it was going to be, because I was hoping to come through those corners at a much greater speed. So what I'm going to do is turn around in a minute and go back, and hopefully won't be behind another vehicle. So let me just find somewhere to turn around. So let's try this again. Hopefully I can get a bit more speed up. I'm going to allow a gap between me and those vehicles in front. So I'll hold back a bit here to allow a larger gap to develop there, and then hopefully I can go through these bends at a bit of some speed. Right, let's put that on, and it's now doing the steering. Let's just whack the speed up to 50. Right, it's doing it all. So what I found is a lot of cars can't cope with these corners when they're doing the lane keep and the full sort of driving, as it were. So a couple of examples: the Hyundai Ioniq 28 kilowatt hour, the older version, which came out in 2016, handled this incredibly well. The later model, the 38 kilowatt hour Ioniq that came out in 2020 or 2019, didn't handle this so well and couldn't cope with the corners. So that system was slightly worse. But obviously a lot of cars now, a lot of modern cars have this technology, and they do this semi-autonomous driving. But as you can see, this Citroen e-C4 handles this really well. I've got to touch the steering wheel, but it's handling it very well. And actually, before they change the speed limit on here, when you approach this at another 10 miles an hour more, it is a little bit scary when the car's driving itself going around these bends. But let me just touch the steering wheel. These bends are sharp enough for a lot of cars to give up, but this is doing it just fine. So I find this road is a good test to see how good the self-driving is in a lot of modern cars. Some can do it, some can't. They can all do the straights and the more gentle corners just fine, but they all have a point where they switch off at a certain radius, because I guess it's because the camera can't see far enough ahead. But on the Citroen e-C4, it does a good job, and I would say this is one of the better self-driving systems. Sorry, not self-driving, self-steering systems. So let me just increase the speed to 70, because we've currently we're in a faster bit of road. Right, so I've now set the cruise control to 70. Our speed is really picking up. And so as you can see, on a slightly straighter road, it handles it very well. Interestingly, see, a car has pulled out in front. So I'm approaching this at 70. He's accelerating, but in a minute, there we go. The radar's picked him up, and it's slowing me down and now matching me to that Ford Galaxy in front. I've just got to touch the steering. So what this system doesn't do is lane changes. So if I put my indicator on, it doesn't do a lane change. I've got to steer myself. But what it does is, when you put the indicator on, it turns off the lane keep assist, and it allows you to change lane, and then as soon as you're in your lane, it automatically turns on the lane keep again. So it is a good system. It works as well as any other. I would say actually it's one of the better ones. Obviously not in the same league as a Tesla. They have got it cracked, but in the UK our laws don't allow full self-driving yet, hence why we've got to be holding the steering wheel. So the standard systems in a Tesla, unless you pay for the upgrades, in the UK the standard systems in a Tesla work exactly the same as this. If you pay the extra, you do get the lane change, but that's a bit pointless at the moment until our laws change. So here's a test two. I'm approaching this at 70 miles an hour, and look at that, it's handling that really well. I've got to drop my speed now to 50. Right, let's see how it handles this corner. Very well indeed. So the speed limit is 50 here. Oh, it's getting a bit close to the middle. There we go, it's moved back. It's always when a lorry's coming the other way. No, I'm going to move again because I'm a bit close to that truck. So it does like getting a bit close to the centre of the road there. Yeah, it's getting very close to the white line there as well. Now it's pulled back in. So it does have a tendency to... That's making me a bit nervous when there's cars ready to pull out and the car's driving itself. But yeah, it does have a tendency sometimes on a bend to get a bit near the middle of the road. Right, it's now flashing at me because I haven't been holding the steering wheel enough. But it's back on again, the green lines have come on, the lane keeps back, and yeah, there we go. Works very well. So, I think that's it for this video. I just wanted to show you how these systems work and just show you how well it works in the Citroen e-C4. It's quite impressive. At the end of the day, they all do the same sort of thing, but some are better than others. Some sort of bounce you from side to side a little bit more. Some can't cope with corners. Some can't cope with the white lines when they're faded a little bit. Some can't see hard curbs on the edge of the road. But this is a good system. Personally, I don't use it very often. But anyway, I think that'll do for this video. If you found it useful, as always, please do click the thumbs up button. That really does help. Do subscribe to the channel. And if you want to see more videos about the Citroen e-C4, then I'll put a link in the video description below to a playlist where you can see other videos I've made about these cars. And I'll see you on the next video.